You think what? He's never been this bad. He's bad.
So, we have been looking at the problems of inequality in society. And we started looking at poverty. On poverty. We started looking at problems of inequality, right? What is inequality? Imbalance in the receiving of opportunity, imbalance in the provision of opportunity, the treatment of people is different, right? Others are crying and others are smiling. Why? Because not all of us can get the same opportunities. Not all of us can be given in society. And we have had great challenges. If you looked at the European world, much of the underprivileged societies have been Africans or the Latin America, the Latinos, you know, and other races. The world has been treated as a superior race. And this has triggered us coming to ourselves where we continue to promote inequality in different sectors of life. And one of these is we're talking about poverty. That unequalness in treating. Okay? So when we talk about problems of inequality, we are looking at poverty, we are looking at racism, we are looking at what else? Tribalism, gender.
Okay.
What? Ageism. He said, now how does inequality come? Okay? Oh God. So when we talk about poverty, we look at how do you analyze poverty as a contributing factor to inequality? Or how would we take inequality as a contributing factor to poverty? Which one contributes to what? Inequality contributes to poverty. Ah.
When they are giving government,
how can we become people for when we are qualified differently? What do you mean by putting the non equal? They are going to tell you that we have got a system where there is a system of promoting people. What does it say? Where those who have just been employed are going to have a specific entry point. And then as you move on, you are promoted based on your contribution.
Yes, they can see that it means that you set them for the two parties, the voters, then they are not allowed to be in the
country. We have made such complaints in sometimes in the police before some officers are going to the threatening. try to manage and work this office to go and then because they have been there for long, but no promotion, no increment. People have gone to school to upgrade, but there's no any increment in terms of salaries. And then in most cases what you are told is we have no funds. So if you want to upgrade, then you must follow the procedures that are there in government for somebody to upgrade. Don't just finish your first degree or your diploma and then you go by yourself. That will not affect us because we know and we have to put it in plan that we have sent so many people for studies or so many people are studying. And so that when they finish, we know that in our plan, we may, if funds available, raise their fund. What about that? So we say everybody has about the ability to become rich. But because of inequality, people are poor. Some people are poor. Okay? When we talked about that, the class of conflict is the one which has brought a lot of problems to society. There are others who are rich and others are poor, and so what we want is for those who are poor to become rich. Right? And so there is a class struggle. Okay. Yes, sir? We're supposed to be here?
No, yeah, we need to be in this class, so let me just check that again. Okay.
Okay. Maybe we have encroached your class. Yeah. Okay. Others try to find the easiest way to become rich. But still, you found it. There is. And so we're saying when the rich realize the maliciousness of the poor, they try to protect themselves from the rich, I mean from the poor, so that what they have should not be accessed by the poor. And so we build walls, tall walls, for instance, with electricity. The glass is still there. How else now would you say inequality is bringing poverty? Let's discuss. In your own perspective, how is inequality bringing poverty to our society, to our community? Would we say there is inequality in rural areas? Huh? What kind of inequality can happen in rural areas?
You may just choose people near and not living the ones who are
what else do people think? Yeah. So it will be only the reality and the friends who will become rich. Or who will see better things and not the poor. Yeah, so inequality will make the poor poor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Inequality can make the more poor. You are trying to benefit from something, then you say, there is a way that we have to do things. How? We need to send these things to the one person who must be in charge. And who is that person? It's the chief. When the chief receives that, why should my relatives be suffering when I'm here? You know, I'm the key person. So this is what happens in most cases, even when I'm the boss at work, because I know that there's a vacancy coming. Man, come. We will cut the labor force if there's a vacancy. When they come to my side, I know how to bring them in, right? So definitely my relatives are going to be fired. And when I bring in my relatives, those who are supposed to be there, who have been trained, who have not been trained, who have compromised quality, right? Development continued and there the equality of receiving opportunity in such a society.
What about inequality in relationships?
Inequality in relationships. Bringing poverty? Can you explain?
No, actually, you.
If I'm blocking you to access quality education, to go and do some business, or to go and sell tomatoes at the market, you will not have anything to do. You get your friend or husband is broke, and the kid needs to eat or feed at home. Then you become a baker. You know, there are some families where you see the wife is always big. Whenever the neighbor brings something good from work, you see, looking beautiful. Like, what does it all mean? Very beautiful, but miserable. Why? Because she's not provided the platform to be used. So because I want to be more important in a relationship, then I block the other person to be dependent on me. Instead of the family growing richer, it's only one sided. And I have to produce, it's me to produce every time so that I feel I'm a man. That man that I am, right? And this connects also to gender inequality. Where at a certain point men have been, have felt so much, we are the ones who are in charge here. We are the ones who know how to do things here. You do nothing. You know nothing. And so, starting from your home, you have to take care of the children. I will give you many children so that you are kept busy, you know, as a woman. And by the time I come back from work, you are tired, you are useless. You have to wait for bread and run after me as the king, the main provider. So your creativity goes down. You feel useless. You have one, two children with no education. You feel you are worthless before society. So yes, it goes even in relationships. Okay. So gender is one of the ways that has brought a lot of problems of inequality. A lot of NGOs have been formed because we want to bring that aspect of equality. Is it possible to attend it? Can women be equal to men? Can men be equal to women?
Yes.
In what circumstances? Are we not exaggerating?
We are not.
How? Not. I am not. Look at how your faces are looking. Very beautiful and bright and light. Now look at our faces. Very beautiful. Why? Because much of the whatever is age is given to you. From your parents, you suck. Boyfriend, you suck. Husband, you suck. Gender inequality. At its peak, there's no peace for the other gender now because the other one is trying to be equal but has overtaken the equalness. In the form of corrupting our minds. If you love me, you love me. If you don't do this, you don't love me. You will have to take me to school. Next in the future, you never get the way of no, you still have a PhD. You can marry the general government, the loser in the house. No, they will learn something. That's not how all men behave. They promote their behavior. From there, you find me. I'm walking on foot, I'm going to that. Gender inequality. Unfortunately, as men, we fall so blind. In the same, I'll buy it. Otherwise, if I don't buy it, someone else will not cheat me. You don't know that the car is a passport for her to get a higher man, a richer man. Gender is the status of being male. Right? But how is it coming in to have brought inequality? The practices that have been done in the past have promoted much of one sex or one gender. One sex to be more important than the other. And because the other sex felt, no, there's something that can be done. We can also become useful to society as well as special to ourselves. Can you do something? Organizations. Feminist organizations that is coming up. Women have also got a role to play in society that can turn tables around. Yes. Once you empower a woman, things really change. But it does not mean that you empower a woman, you empower the nation. That's a very big bias, right? It's like, it is only when you empower a woman that you are going to empower the nation only. And when you empower a man, no, in this aspect, right? Empower a woman, empower the whole nation. And even our thinking that parents started changing now. Okay? Educate the girl child. Why? Even when she goes out there, her responsibility to receive the profits from her husband and then from her work, she may help him as more. So she's a great asset, right? Unlike this Andrew boy. Once he marries, he concentrates on his engine. friends and the children. And so you have no time to start looking after the parents. Right? And so it's like once you have the little child, wasted asset. Very wasted. He will go very far and take care of his family. Do I agree with that? Why? Because the woman is the one who has got the key to deny. Go this direction. Remote control. Here, do this.
Even in the workplaces, if the woman is the boss,
the thinking would be, as Andrea mentioned about these men, they think they are always superior. I will show them. Instead of the normal workplace and ethics, it goes the other way. Why? There is already a stereotype that men take women as useless. So I need to show them once I am in that position. So what happens at the place of work? The men are intimidated. Because most women will try to prove themselves that I can do things better than you. And sometimes even they're lying them or not giving them opportunities. And then what we'll do is we just tell them and let them do. They are the ones owning the show. All this is happening because women also want to feel useful and worthy. In workplaces, I want to be considered that we all went to the same school, so we can also become directors as mentors. And that's why you have many of the young girls being the majority in schools, universities now. Where have the boys got gender equality? We have promoted too much of the girl church. The girl church page. What, you know? We have forgotten that boys also need encouragement. If you look at most of the girls around here, they are driving, right? And see that? They are coming with cars. Look at our boys now. Why not? What has happened? Okay, we're talking about gender equality, let it be equal, right? But why? The woman doesn't want to be equal to you. Everyone wants to be equal to level. And so, if I'm going to get a boyfriend, I'll make sure that I get a boyfriend who, someone who will be able to provide for me that when it's my birthday, it comes, come now. That is the one I want for the little. Is that equalness or is competition of my happiness? Guys, wake up. Colego Moni. Wake up. I think you were telling me that. Yes, don't worry. But these are some of the things, practical things, when we try to analyze problems in the aspect of gender that bring inequality. So due to the treatment that some of the women have received from some harsh men, others do a revenge kind of. It's a reaction kind of formation. They say, okay, they cannot do this to us, then we can do better harm. Yes. It's like a situation where someone is has harmed you in a very strange way. You caught your partner in the act, right? Committing that act. And then instead of reacting, you just go quiet. Just come out of the whatever the place they were doing their diagnosis. And you go. You allow them to leave. The man leaves nicely, so Although he's afraid that he may receive an axe, but you just need him like that to go. And the woman also, no man, you go to the kitchen, you cook as a man, right? Before food is ready, suddenly eat. You even buy your wine and your bottle of wine. Let's eat and celebrate. Are you going to be sweet? Second day goes, I'm not asking you anything. The third day goes, I'm not asking you anything. What happens? Pack all your balloons and you disappear. What has made you to disappear? Guilt. I don't know what he's thinking. Maybe he's planning a very painful death for me, so I better leave. Run. So others may plan to revenge in a very bitter way. When they are treated badly. And issues of gender inequality still drop in or fall. So we are saying, more privileges for long have been given to boys and men. And now the feminist organizations have come in again to promote more of the females and girls. And we're feeling left out somehow as men and boys. So, how do you think we could solve these gender inequality issues? Understanding that each and everyone is important, is right. But you can also contribute as a lady, as a man, equally, is important. Accepting each other in society that you also have a part to play, just like an organism works. When each and every part of it is okay, it's important. When we are family, the other one is been given duties of soothing the little ones, another one washing plates, another one making the bed, another one. At the end of it, it's breakfast time all over. I'm going to happily sit around the table or around somewhere, and then we eat, knowing that everyone has performed, has played a part. We all understand what is happening here. Okay? Then we have the rest, ethnicity and minority groups. How is inequality coming in the area of racism. So we talk about racism, ethnicity, minority groups. A lot of wars have broken up. Violent crimes and incidences have come up in our society because of issues of racism, issues of tribalism. We are the ones who are the first. You are useless. You are selfish. Which tribe in our country is considered to be selfish? Without thinking, because it has been planted in there, it's been a belief that this group is towards the water. I'm a friend of Panga, they won't come, they want to be by themselves. This is the places of where they go to Gabeza, the standards will be concurrent. We know it, yeah? We don't want to mention it. Who doesn't know it? And when others are just here at that. What's your name?
I am John Peace.
Automatically, with the other tribe, you feel Chintima. What's wrong with you? It's just a time, man. I see a beautiful man, handsome man, beautiful girl. What? I am from the north.
Hey.
I surrender.
Why?
I will be beaten of more death. Who is going to make themselves here? No. I give up. I'll be thinking of,
when I'm shopping the room, I can see them as well.
And then the name is drawing with my form 4 failed statistics. But it's okay.
Move on. Yes, it's like you have something to say. Ah, no. Fine.
There was a certain guy.
I don't think over. But some young people
approached this beautiful elegant looking young lady.
The need was also high.
During the introduction, the guy introduces himself.
I'm a diploma.
At this level, he's done something great, right?
Yeah. And coming from this family, you know.
In BC. It's your turn now. Introduce yourself.
Hello. I am Nerissa.
Start looking at the name.
I'm Nerissa.
Something.
I'm from. Somewhere, and I'm doing my PhD. I'm a PhD student.
Hi! This guy just was paralyzed.
Why?
It was too much for him.
A young girl doing a PhD already, and I'm saying, I'm doing it wrong.
I'm feeling myself.
He had to go to friends and ask friends, please, where do I do? I don't have the courage to even ask her out again. And she started asking him, like, no, you are so suddenly. What's wrong? You are not texting me, you are not just
I know. Why? Sometimes there are certain situations that just bring us down. There are certain races which seem to be superior than others. When we look at one man, white man today, even when we look at our own here, what comes to our mind immediately? He's rich, he's a well-behaved person, he's coming from, you know, very educated, and sometimes we have Azungus who come with dreaded diploma, but we want to give them ears that whatever they say is correct, we'll hear it. Yeah? We have been looking for a resident vice chancellor at our university. And you know what people say? You know, as an upcoming university, we are looking for those retired professors from Europe so that they could come here and make our university connected, and can we connect our university ourselves? We have no trust in our own people, and we cannot empower them because we have seen him getting a master's and getting his PhD from here. What can he do? What would they come from the young people? The long matter of meaning, what would they come from the normal people? The two matter of meaning, what would they come from, you know? Now, Russia, coming from, an African person who sells the fellow African person to go and be a slave and wait for the Europeans. And so we are coming in as foreign people. Who are your waiters? Right? So even when that ban has been removed on you to say you are no longer slaves, how are we going to treat you? How? Mwana utu musungesi, tamute iwa unduwa anti atu katate nato, or my brother's daughter or son, right? I already have one of my kids, right? Okay? And then, how are my kids going to treat this one? If I tell the child to say, you should be calling me daddy, okay? I already have my kids, right? How are you going to feel as my kids when, and therefore I now try to be more responsible than my own kids? What happens? You go to call you, then he's out again! Right? We're trying to put you in your stress, in your place. You're not our daddy. He is our daddy. He's not your daddy. Have you ever experienced that, and how painful it is? This is not your country, my friend. You are a black Americano. Black, eh? Black American. You have your own origin in Africa. And they will keep reminding you of your life in that society. And sometimes this is what brings about barbaric behaviors. Sometimes when we are trying to blame the South Africans, they have felt the pain of being treated as useless. Julius Malema, have you ever heard of him? Julius Malema. Have you ever heard his speech? Yeah?
No.
Just by name. Watch on TikTok. When he comes out to speak, he's a person who is ready to kill for those who offend the rights of the black man. And he says, for me, I can't let my fellow believe.